What up everybody, it's your boy TK and welcome to yet another YouTube video. Today I'm gonna show you how to make your photos 10 times better just by using adjustment tools in Adobe Lightroom. First of all, hope all of you are having an amazing day. My name is Kristijan Lizić, and in case you can't pronounce it or remember it, you can just call me Chris, which is the name I use all across my social media. And in case you don't follow me on any of them, you can check them out in the description below the video. And I'd highly appreciate it if you consider supporting me with a follow. Anywho, as I said, today we're gonna be discussing how to make your photos 10 times better just by using adjustment filters in Adobe Lightroom. I know a lot of you never actually properly use these tools. I know a lot of people who use Lightroom every single day, but almost never use adjustment tools, which I think is a pity because they let you re-edit a part of the image, excluding the part of the image that's not affected with the adjustment filters, which is pretty amazing because sometimes we get stuck into editing one part of the image, but something else in the same photo just doesn't look right. And that's why I'm gonna show you how I use these tools. So without further ado, alright, I have some photos down here that I downloaded online, and yeah, I didn't have that much time to shoot lately, so yeah, I'll just be using one of these. I'd like to give a credit to the photographer, but I don't know who he is, so in case you know who took this shot, you can just let me know in the comments below and I'll tag his IG profile or YouTube channel, anything down below in the description. But anyway, let's just proceed with everything. So we'll be using this shot, as you can see. I'm gonna just apply some preset from the new preset pack that I'm working on. I just use this one. It's gonna be a good example. So we don't have to do any adjustments here. I'm just gonna show you how I use my adjustment tools because the preset is looking pretty damn good here. Let's just amplify the shot with some adjustments. First off, I'm gonna use a graduated filter for the sky over here. I don't want it to look this way. I think it can look much better if we do this. First of all, I just drop one gradual filter like this, just covering the whole sky. Alright, that seems about right. First of all, I would like to make it a bit warmer, just to make some contrast between the photo and the sky. 38 seems about right. Let's drop it a bit more down. Okay, that's it. Let's drop down the exposure. Okay, seems cool. Highlights, a bit up. Okay, this looks dope. Shadows almost all the way down. Now let's boost up those whites. Looks really punch, really good. 52 looks really good. Blacks, let's go a bit down with them. Minus 10 is alright. And let's just drop down the saturation because this just looks unnatural if you look at the whole photo. So yeah, 48, minus 48, okay. Now what I would do, this looks much better, you can see here by clicking this little box. You can see before and after. I already like it much better, but I still think we can add some more contrast. Let's just drop down a new graduated filter. Halfway is gonna be good. A bit more, okay, yeah. Let's just reset this. Alt plus here, reset, okay. Alright, I don't think we will have to do a lot here. Let's just add some blues back into the sky. Perhaps even a bit more graduated. Yep, looks dope. And drop down the exposure. Just that. Oh, that's dope. That's sick. That just looks amazing. Really nice, contrasty, punchy. I think this looks amazing. Okay, and let's use another adjustment filter. We can use adjustment brush here. I want to show off this part a bit more. I want it to stand out of the photo so we have like a contrast contrasty look throughout a photo, like from the sky to these hills, to this wood, to this bridge and to this grass over here. So yeah, let's just blow this up a bit. I think the photographer was focusing on this as the emphasis of the photo, so I think that's gonna be right to do. Let's just use the brush. We can check this box just so we can see what we covered while brushing. I'm gonna close up here just to not go overboard. I'm not gonna be too precise just for the sake of the tutorial. I don't have that time, but yeah, I think we can do a pretty good job. It doesn't have to be like this. Yeah, blow this brass up as well. It's gonna look good. You can leave like a little spots over here. We can easily add some more afterwards in case you don't like it, so it's not really that big of a problem. So yeah, just make sure everything that you want to be in the shot is selected, and then afterwards if need be we will fix that, fix some details. Okay, uncheck this box, and now let's have some fun. Let's blow up the exposure, plus 60, okay. Let's add some massive contrast over here. Highlights almost all the way up. Shadows a tad down. Whites, what we're gonna do here, yeah, probably just push them to about plus 20. I'm not gonna touch blacks, I'm gonna add a bit clarity though. I'm gonna give up that little punch. Oh yeah, this looks pretty nice. And just desaturate it a bit because all of these settings set it up a little bit of color, so we want to get rid of that. And I believe this looks amazing. Look at the results. Oh yeah, this just looks freaking dope. And in case you're wondering how the before and after looks, you can just click here and you can see the raw file and the edited file. I think we killed it over here, and the adjustment tools just did an amazing job. If you want, we can get rid of them and just let me show you how it looks without them and what you can gain just by using some adjustment tools. And that's basically it. Only problem with this trick is that it won't work on every single photo. It will work on most of them because I've been using it a lot on my photos and almost on every single photo. But I guarantee if you go creative on it, you're gonna have an amazing results, but you gotta have some fun with it. These settings is just something you play around. You can get a million different varieties of how it's gonna look just by adjusting those 7 or 8 sliders of settings. Yeah, you're gonna have to have some fun, edit a lot of photos, do this like thousands of times over until you figure out how it works, how it's gonna look the best and everything. So. But I think it's an amazing trick and I think it's worth sharing it with you. So in case you did like it and plan on using it on your future photos and you plan posting those photos on social media, please use some sort of a hashtag. Let's say hashtag editlikeTK so I can check out what you guys did with some of my tricks. And also make sure to let me know what kind of a tutorial you want me to do next in the comment section below. And yeah, I guess that's gonna be it for today. Thank you all so much for watching. Really do appreciate it. I'm gonna do my best to improve these videos and to post more often in the future. And in case you did enjoy it, please leave a like, comment down below what you thought of this video, what you would like to see in the future. Subscribe, and you know what? I'll see you in the next one.